Hello there, my name is Adine. This is my beautiful wife, Melinda. Welcome to our YouTube channel.
Welcome back if you're a longtime subscriber, or welcome if this is your first time here. Today we are going to be covering some easy intro categories to get you started on eBay.
It's a great way to make extra money. It's a great side hustle. It's a great hobby, whatever you want to turn it into, or a full-time career if you want to do that. And we want to cover five categories that are super low risk, require almost no testing, and you can find them easily, readily available in all sorts of locations for cheap, so you can flip them online for profit. Let's jump right into this video.
One category that is very easy to sell in is shoes. The reason is because they're very easy to pack, very easy to make it to their destination. We have a very low return rate on shoes as well. Another thing that makes them appealing to sell is that they're available anywhere. You can find them at garage sales, you can find them at thrift stores, you can get them at volume, at the bins. You can find a lot of liquidation companies that specialize in shoes. The options for finding them are basically endless. And everybody always needs shoes. If you're not familiar with shoes, there's a huge demand for them across multiple platforms: Poshmark, eBay, Mercari, Depop, basically any of them. We sell a lot on Facebook Marketplace as well. They're an easy flip if you check condition and you check the brands and you check comps when you go into a thrift store. They're also very easy to look up most of the time because they will either have a style code number that you can type in, or they say their names right on the shoes. So it's very easy to search for comps as well, so you know that you're getting a shoe that has a good resale value. We have only about a 2% return rate on our shoes. That's because we check for condition while we're in the store. With any shoe, you're gonna wanna pick it up, and the first thing is turn it over, check the treads. You're looking for any major wear. Usually it's gonna be at the heels or the toes. Sometimes it's all through it. If it's a running shoe, for instance, and the treads are just flat, you're not going to want to pick that up because that's no good for a runner who would be the main market for that shoe. You'll also want to check the inside. One area that gets a lot of wear is the back heel area here. If there's a hole, that's usually where they're going to be. But of course, don't forget to check around anywhere this fabric is. Sometimes at the rubber, regardless of shoe style, it'll start to come up. If it's beyond repair, you'll want to leave that as well because water can get in there and it'll just cause more damage. People won't want to buy that. Dirt and scuffs are all fixable things that you can remedy with a little bit of elbow grease. We do have another video on how we clean and process shoes. We'll link that video here so that you can check that out if you haven't already. Here's just a quick sample of some shoes that we've picked up to resell. As you can see, leather fashion sneakers, skate shoes, running shoes. We also sell a lot of casual shoes, also boots. These are all about $5 to $7 at your local thrift store. So it's a very low risk category to get into in terms of the upfront cost as well. So these ones here, we paid about $5, and these are valued anywhere from $25 to $40 on the used shoe resale market.
Another category that's very easy to get into with minimal experience is sporting goods. This would include softball, baseball bats, which are really easy to identify because the information is right on the bat. Includes baseball and softball gloves. I'll show you a couple examples of those. You can find these everywhere: thrift stores, estate sales, especially yard sales, garage sales, as seasons change and, you know, the kids, the adults, whoever, get an update or upgrade to their equipment. Golf clubs, tennis rackets. All of these items typically have a manufacturer or a brand name, a model number right on them, so you can easily look them up on eBay or whatever platform you're selling on. And again, you can easily find them. The USPS or the post office, they make tube-like boxes you can get for free to ship them in. Those are really good for baseball bats and golf clubs. And then for other items like baseball mitts or gloves, you can just put them in a poly bag, so they're pretty easy to ship as well. Tennis rackets are a little bit more challenging because you need a rectangular, narrow box to ship them in, but you can find those online in bulk, or you can find them, you know, at a recycling dumpster, for example. They're a low-risk item because most of the time, whoever is buying it, they know what they're looking for either their kids or an adult league, for example. So again, the return percentages are between 2 and 3%. We've never had a return on any sporting good item, which is pretty awesome. Let me pen over a couple of examples of items you can look for to flip online. Here we have some baseball or softball gloves. We have three different ones, three different brand names. You want to look out for Rawlings, and right on the inside, it's going to tell you the number. This one is actually a special edition Ken Griffey Jr., so it commands a little bit of a higher price. And then right on the inside here, it actually tells you the size, so you don't even have to worry about measuring it. This is a Wilson. This one already sold. It sold within the same day it was listed. Again, the measurements are in there. It's a fast pitch leather glove. The size is in there as well. Right on the inside here where my thumb is after the 12 and a half inch is the actual model number, so you can easily identify it. And then this is a Mizuno glove. Again, all the measurements informations are right in. So it's really easy to identify and really easy to look these up. On average, these are worth about $25 to $50 each. Some of them command a much higher price, up to $100, $150 if you find the right one. A couple of tennis rackets. These are our personal ones that we've actually thrifted. This is a Prince. And again, right here, it'll tell you exactly the brand or the model number. It's going to give you all the information on the inside of the handle. It's going to tell you the size. All of the information is usually right in this area. Here's another one. This is a Wilson. It tells you it's a Prestige 95. And with this Wilson, all the information is right here, so you can get everything you need right from the handle, including the size, all of that good stuff. Grip, you can usually find really cheap, so you can actually re-grip or retape the handlebars if you want to, or you can just sell as is and expect that the athlete's going to do it themselves.
One category that we've sold a lot in is pots and pans during our time as resellers. It's very straightforward, probably one of the easiest categories you can sell in. They're generally undervalued at thrift stores, garage sales. People are just looking to sell them for 50 cents, a couple bucks to get rid of an old used pot or pan. But this is a category that people use daily. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, they get used. And then when you want to get new pots and pans, you're looking for quality ones. And a lot of the brands that we sell hold their value because they are a top quality. And retail, it's hundreds and hundreds of dollars if you've ever had to buy a new set of pots and pans. So you can bring a lot of value by offering some pre-owned excellent condition options. Some beginner tips of what to look out for. Stainless steel tends to do better than anodized or non-stick skillets or fry pans, pots and pans. There are some exceptions to that, but if you are going to pick up the non-stick, you really have to make sure that there's not a lot of major scratching at the bottom. So be on the lookout for that. Even if they're dirty wherever you're picking them up from, pots and pans are very easy to clean. That's what they're designed for. Hand washing with just some basic soap and water can usually do wonders. If they're really burnt, you can use steel wool or a Brillo pad, something with a lot of texture, and really go just use some elbow grease, get in there, and it usually shines up really nicely. They're also great because they're not going to break in shipment. That's what holds a lot of people back from selling on eBay, is they get intimidated by shipping. Unless you're shipping glassware type of pots and pans, which if you are getting started, I would shoot to avoid that and stick with the stainless and the regular cookware type, because nothing is going to happen to them. You know, they're hard, they're durable, they're going to make it to their location. We've never had anything that wasn't glassware break in shipment when it comes to pots and pans. All you need is some brown packaging paper, a box, and that's it. You just wrap them up in the brown packaging paper to prevent any extra scratches or dings during shipment, and it's good to go. Once you get comfortable with a few pots and pans brands, they're very easy to identify. A couple here is a trademark Revereware. You're gonna notice the copper bottoms. The better ones are more vintage, made in USA. Sometimes they'll have the quart size. Sometimes you can measure that just by taking 4 cups for 1 quart and pouring it into the pot or pan, so you can give an accurate description of it. This is a Revereware tea kettle. Tea kettles also sell very well. They're very popular. If you've ever bought a modern tea kettle, you've probably experienced them wearing out or breaking in some way after a short period of time. These vintage ones hold up very well. They heat up quickly and they retain their value. They generally sell for us anywhere from $30 up to $60+, depending on the size and condition. This is an example of something that isn't stainless. This would be that sort of anodized metal material. And just always flip them over. This is Calphalon. Calphalon is a good brand to look out for. And this one is unique because it was made in Ireland, but it's a USA brand. We did do a whole video on pots and pans brands, so I won't cover a lot of them here, but we will link that video so you can go ahead and watch it. It covers multiple brands, how to clean them, and a lot of detailed information specifically on this category.
Next up, let's talk about toys. Now, video games is one category that sells extremely well online, and you can find video games and video game consoles pretty much everywhere. However, they are a little bit risky because you need to have the console to verify that the games actually work, and you need to have a little bit of technology, and you can't do it on the spot. So you go and buy a Nintendo from someone on Facebook Marketplace, they tell you it works, you get it home, it doesn't work, now what? So it's a little bit riskier. Let's talk about toys that don't have that risk associated with them. So in this category, it's pretty vast. What I'm gonna talk about are, you know, plushes, board games, things like that. One category we've done really well in is vintage board games. Even if the board games are not complete, you can typically part out just the pieces. Just a few days ago, we ended up selling just the Scooby-Doo pieces for Scooby-Doo Clue for $15 plus shipping, and we only paid $1 for entire board game. That's just one example. You can also look out for some plush, including Disney plush, Mickey, Minnie Mouse, Dumbo, all those characters. Those usually do pretty well, especially if you can find rarer ones, or ones in really good sizes, or ones in groups or bundles. Fisher Price, GeoTrax, or a couple of other ones you can look out for that you can buy in bulk, usually off of Facebook Marketplace, or they're readily available at yard sales and garage sales, thrift stores. They're easy to identify, they don't require a lot of testing, and they're easy to look up and sell. Plush are extremely easy to package. A lot of this stuff is not very complex at all. You can find Legos, vintage toys, modern action figures, etc. as well. Legos sell really well for us. Even if the entire set is not complete, you can still sell it, or you can sell it by the pound or in bulk. When it comes to vintage, there's definitely a lot of money in toys that people undervalue. So for example, old He-Man, Transformers, G.I. Joe from the 90s, you know, 80s, 70s, the older, and of course condition and accessories matter, the better. If you can find old 70s G.I. Joes with accessories, you're looking at a lot of money. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles is another one where you can find pretty much everywhere at yard sales, and if you find specific small accessory pieces, people are willing to pay hundreds of dollars to complete their old childhood collection. Any sort of action figures, you know, Batman, Superman, Spider-Man, all of those fellows, you can usually find pretty easily. I'll show you a couple of examples of a little bit harder to find, but you can still find this stuff because people just have it laying around, and again, they're just trying to get rid of it, and you can flip it online to make money. Let me show you a couple of examples. One reason why you can find this stuff very cheap at yard sales and garage sales is that typically the kids moved out and left their old stuff and the parents want their house back. And they're just trying to move this stuff. They're not trying to find max value for it. This is a set that's already sold. This is a GeoTrax by Fisher-Price set. It's just like an airplane, so you put it on this little arm, they swing around. So a nice toy set. With this stuff, you can sell individual pieces with remotes, or you can sell tracks or bundles. Really straightforward to look up, really straightforward to identify. Plushes, this is a Cabbage Patch. These are easy to find at thrift stores, especially at estate sales, for just a couple of dollars. Look out for Strawberry Shortcake plush. Those do really well. You can sell them for $50 up to $100 and more if you find them. Here's another brand to look out for. This is Fisher-Price Little People. The vintage stuff does really well, but the modern stuff holds its value too. This is just a castle with princesses. There's noises that are made when you do certain actions. You can find it really cheap. Monda found this one for $5 with a bunch of accessories, and some accessories have already sold. Some action figure examples. These are Spider-Mans from the 90s. This one is worth about $30. This one's worth about $20. Condition does matter sometimes, but hey, look, they're rare to find with the actual accessories still intact. You can find these at estate sales, yard sales, and maybe even buying someone's collection out. And then of course, Legos. They're harder to find sealed, but we found them several times at garage sales for $5 to $10, and we flipped them for $50 to $80 on eBay. Again, they don't have to be sealed, but it definitely does help. Monster High is another one you can look out for. I mean, there's just so many. Toys are definitely money maker on eBay.
Similar to pots and pans, small kitchen appliances are also a very undervalued category by a lot of people. They are plentiful in your local thrift stores, in Goodwills. your neighbor's garage sales. We find them everywhere for very good prices. When you're at the thrift store, they are also very easy to test. All you have to do is find an outlet, plug it in, and make sure that it works. You don't have to use the product specifically for what it was intended to do. For instance, if you get a Ninja, you don't necessarily have to make a smoothie. You do have to test all the functions and make sure everything is working properly. But again, you just do that by plugging it in, turning it on, and running it through the cycles at the store. Especially if you don't have a return policy at your thrift stores, this is an easy way to feel confident when you leave the store that your product will work. I'm gonna pan over some examples and some brands that are really good to keep your eye out for.
Rebel juicers have done very well for us. And when you're working with these bigger, small appliances, look and see if it's worth parting them out. That is how we sell a lot of our units, is we take them apart and sell the replacement pieces separate. So this here would be a piece with the brush. The lid with the pusher would also be a replacement part if this breaks. Many times people already have the unit and they've just broken something on it and they need a replacement part. That'll be especially true with older vintage appliance pieces. And there is a big market for that too, just because these are a little bit more modern. Vintage pieces sell great. Besides Breville, Ninja is a great brand to look out for. They do have very quality items. We actually have a Ninja, we love it. Again, when we find them with all these accessories, we will part them out and sell this canister separately. The motor can sell separately. These smaller ones can sell in sets of two or three. And that helps with shipping as well. You'll have smaller packages to ship out. They're a little bit more complicated than regular pots and pans because you do have to bubble wrap some pieces, but they are durable and sturdy. They're made usually from thicker plastic, so it's still very safe to ship them.
A couple other quality brands are Cuisinart, especially their food processors, and Sunbeam, especially those vintage Sunbeam mixers. Those sell well. And again, some of these can sell very well all together as one unit if you prefer to do it that way. But a lot of them have many parts. You get a lot of listings for one price. So there you have it. There's five categories that are very easy to get started on. Low risk, easy to ship, can find them everywhere. This video hopefully will help people who are a little bit intimidated in getting started on eBay and give you some things to look for if you're out garage sailing.
And there's no way anyone's going to try to scam you for a plush or some of these older toys. You know, obviously, if you have something that's very high value, wait until you build up your listings and get a lot of reviews first and maybe reach the top seller level, depending on what platform you're selling on, so you can have some protection. But usually most people are not scamming you for Breville juicer parts or, you know, pots and pans, things like that.
That's right. We've never gotten scammed in either of those categories. So they are pretty safe and it's a great way to get started and just figure things out as you build your business on eBay.
And also it's a way to reduce your cost because you're not going to be spending a lot of money on this stuff. This stuff is typically found for a few dollars, you know, each. You might spend $50, $100 to get started, but you can find a lot of this stuff at your own house sitting in a junk drawer or your parents' house, your old vintage toys, whatever it is, just get started. That's the whole point. We really hope this video helped you guys. If it did,
go ahead, give us the thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you like content like this.
Thank you so much, and we'll see you guys in the next one.
Take care.